Hey everybody, happy Saturday afternoon. This is going to be a long video. I know some, like I've said before, I know some of you get upset when there's a lot of drama on my videos instead of just art. But, you know, sometimes with mental health, there comes drama, especially if you're talking about it, okay? It is what it is. You can be talking about it and somebody else can make the drama, you know, it is what it is. So, but I'm going to make a conscious effort to end this video on a good note, on a positive note. I think we could all use it. I'm struggling real hard today, I'm not going to lie. So, I'm not going to do the positivity bag or the legging reveal until towards the end of this video when we start talking about positive stuff, okay? Because I want to leave that as the last thing for you so you're not carrying at the end, you're not, you know, carrying the dramatic and the yucky parts that I have to talk about today. Okay, so yesterday a lot of people got upset with me because of my video to Mrs. Portland about the homophobic slurs. And, you know, people think that because you want to be a positive person and talk about mental health and stuff like that, that you can't ever be angry. You're not allowed to be angry. You're not allowed to reprimand somebody for vile, vicious behavior. Okay? And I don't know why that thinking is the way it is. Because I can tell you right now, if you're following anybody who is 24/7 positive, 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 and there's never a bad thing, you're seeing a shell, because nobody's life is like that. Even if it's just one day out of 7 years, there was one day. Okay, you see what I mean? No, you know, people, I've said it before, and I'm going to continue to say, people mistake my kindness for weakness. That's not it. Just because I want things to be more positive, and just because I want things to be more uplifting, does not mean that I can't be upset or angry, especially at hate attacks, whether it's against me or somebody else. Okay, so let's get that out of the way. You know, people were jumping on me saying that my behavior was awful. You know, how mean I was, blah, blah, blah. Why are none of you jumping on the other person for their behavior? Does that make sense? I mean, it's not like I got on and made up stories about somebody or called them names or something like that. I would never do that. And it's not like I'm making anything up, because, you know, YouTube in the world has seen what's happening before our very eyes. So I don't understand why you all have words for, well, not you all. I've got love. You know, I have more. I want to make this clear. I have more people supporting me than not supporting me. Okay. I want to put that out there. And those are the people that are important to me. Okay. But it's important to me that people understand what I mean about, like, enabling and stuff like that. I think that if someone donates money to somebody else, I don't look at that as enabling, whether it is or isn't. And that's just because it's not my business what people do with their money. Okay. What I do think is enabling, though, is when we encourage the behavior because we think it's funny or because we are entertained. You know, it is not okay to encourage that kind of behavior. It's just not, you guys, okay? But be that as it may, I really don't understand why. I mean, you guys know it's bad behavior. You can see that it's bad behavior. Some of you have been verbally abused by this person. But I'm the bad. Nobody's saying anything. I mean, nobody. The people who are coming to me saying how awful I am for talking about her. and that I'm gossiping. That one cracked me up. But that person, that creator doesn't even, yeah, they are just a blip. You're just a troll blip that doesn't affect me in the least. But I just don't understand why you guys think my behavior for defending somebody, even if that person doesn't want defending, I'm still going to do it. I'm going to stand up when I see injustice. I'm going to stand up when I see meanness and hate and true harassment and true bullying. Okay? That's what I stand up. I'm going to stand up for. And that ties in with mental health, obviously. Whether you're the giver or the receiver. Okay? So, I just ask the next time that you want to lecture me on my behavior, I'm not the only one you should be lectured, is what I'm saying. Actually, I shouldn't be lectured at all, because I am very careful, especially when I talk about other content creators. Okay? I try not to insult. Sometimes, you know, I guess insulting is in the eye of the beholders. I don't know. But, you know, I don't call names. I don't bully and I don't harass, no matter what anybody has told you. Not in high school and not now. Thankfully, according to YouTube, I shouldn't say according to YouTube, but I know YouTube is aware of the harassment and the bullying, and they are looking into it, and they have assured me that yes, there is awareness. That's all I'm going to say on that. So let's look at the video I did yesterday about her and the gay bashing. So now I know a lot of people told me that Save Robbie, went on to say that gay bashing doesn't bother him or something. And that's okay. It doesn't have to bother him. You know what I mean? You guys, you know, some people are like, well, if it doesn't bother him, then, but that's not how that works. Okay. I'm glad it doesn't bother Robbie. I really am. Because that tells me that he has a lot of support, both in his YouTube life and in his personal life. So I am ecstatic that gay slurs do not bother Save Robbie, okay? But Save Robbie is not the only person in the LGBTQ+ community, okay? And just because, you know, and it's not just Save Robbie. There's other people. I've seen it over the years. People, well, I have a gay friend. It doesn't bother. That word doesn't bother them, so I can say it. No, sorry. Mm-mm. Hate speech is hate speech. Bigotry is bigotry. Homophobia is homophobia. Okay? Just because you know one person, or even two, three, or four that are in the LGBTQ community and are okay with gay slurs, does not give anybody the license to just blanket approach people that way. And I don't know Save Robbie, and I don't want to speak for him, but, you know, I assume he would probably agree that just because he doesn't, it doesn't bother him, doesn't mean that it's okay. All right? So let's get that straight. Another thing is I don't care who doesn't like Save Robbie. I don't care if he has posted some crappy stuff. I don't care. And the reason why I don't care is because that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about somebody who donated money to somebody, and that person turned around within a couple hours and just roasted them with gay slurs. Didn't bother them, but you know what? I know personally of about 8 people on YouTube who it did bother, that are part of that community. Okay, so it's not okay, you know, to make blanket statements of, well, since this one person. Just like it's not okay for us to assume that every gay person has a problem with gay slurs, it's also okay it's also not okay to assume that, you know, you can just say what you want to people. I personally found it very offensive, and I know a lot of others did. And, you know, in Oregon, where I'm at, we have very, very strict laws on hate speech, both in person and electronically, don't we, Mrs. Portland? The laws in Oregon are very clear on that. So now, all my drama aside from yesterday, and also, you know, don't come at me with, well, if you're going to talk about it, you have to expect drama back. Make myself clear. I don't care if somebody comes to me and we have a civil discussion. I don't care if somebody says, hey, you know what, and gives me their opinion. But I am never going to, you're never going to see me say, oh, so you think it's okay to use the gay F word slang? Not that anybody did this yesterday. They didn't, but it's happened before. Or, did I say that? Well, you guys know what I'm talking about. The gay slur starts with an F. Just because I talk about, I come out and I say, hey, this person's trying to dox me or this person's trying to hurt me. I don't like it. Knock it off. All of a sudden, I deserve what I got for talking or being in a drama channel or for talking about what somebody had posted. I'm sorry. If somebody does something wrong and I point it out, I'm supposed to be okay with being doxed? Explain that to me. Yeah, it just not how it works, you guys. Or attempted doxing. I think Mrs. Portland's just mad because I took away her power to try and dox me because I don't live where she thinks I do. And I have said a million times, hi, my name is Shannon. My husband is John, and we live in Lincoln City, Oregon. Everybody knows that. But she tried. And she's still trying. She did it again yesterday. But no, it doesn't matter that I talked about her or I pointed out her horrific behavior. We're not talking about me pointing out that somebody doesn't like Labrador puppies or I think they're a jerk because they don't like to show supernatural. No. No. I point out what's happening there because I'm tired of the making a video and then deleting it. And then, so the rest of us are looking like jerks because we've said, hey, don't say that and don't do this. That's against the rules or it's against the law, like doxing is. You know, just stop. And people are like, I don't know what you're talking about. Well, that's because she deleted it. Okay, so if we don't speak about it, and I'm not encouraging anybody to talk about Mrs. Portland or make videos about her or anything. I am not doing that here. All I'm saying is for me is I'm not going to sit back and let somebody affect my life and my mental health without saying something. It's just, it's not going to happen. I'm sorry, you guys. But my drama aside, let's talk a little bit about what happened to Natasha last night. Now, I don't have her permission to speak on this, so I'm not going to go into too, like, horrific detail. But we as parents have all, and if you say you haven't, you're lying. As a parent, if your kid's old enough, I'm not talking about somebody who's got a newborn that's 2 days old, y'all know what I mean. And, you know, none of us are perfect parents, and none of us are born knowing the exact right thing to do with our children. They don't come with a set of instructions like how to set up a stereo. Okay? They don't come with instructions like, you know, some sort of IKEA, let's quick snap them together thing. All right? So anybody who's a parent, has been for a while, you at some point in your life have had a problem or a concern about your child and you've gone to your friend or friends and said, hey, look at this. Should I be worried about this? Or do you think I handled this okay? And the reason why they went to their friends and not just blurted it out to the whole world on their channel is because these were their friends. They thought that they could be trusted. So then when these friends, and I don't know who did it, and I don't care, because that's not my point here. But when those friends then turn around and they screenshot it, which, see, just to screenshot what somebody has shown you. And I know if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, I know this is going to sound like I'm talking in riddles. But if you know, you know. Okay? So, to screenshot what these people screenshot in the first place, you have to wonder, why would you do that? Well, in the first place. So whoever you are that did that, right then, the minute you screenshot that, what was it, years ago, I guess? I'm assuming year, at least a year ago, I think, that this this was screenshot. That right there proves that at some point you are going to have an ulterior motive. And if, you know, and I say evidence because, you know, that's kind of what we're working with here. If it comes out later that that's not what happened, you know, I'll go on and I'll retract. But based on the knowledge that I'm being told now and what's being said, you know, Natasha shared something with some friends. So a written form of communication with her friends, just a couple of them in a private setting. And somebody within that frame of friends then screenshot it, and then somehow it ended up in the hands of another content creator last night. Okay, now, like I said, first y'all are calling Natasha a bad parent. No, I never would have shared that, anything like that, about my kid to people, blah blah blah. Stop it. We're not going to blame the person whose only mistake in this was trusting the people she thought was her friends. That's her only mistake in this scenario, unless other stuff comes out. As far as I know right now, and I'm going on what happened last night, so, well, you know, there could be new information, I don't know. But so here we have somebody who was a friend trying to figure out what to do about, you know, an issue with their child, with their friends, and then somebody snapshots that to hold it for later use. What's worse? Person who trusted their friends or the person who made the snapshot? And then let's take it another step further. What's worse? The person who trusted her friends and wanted advice? Or the person who received that and decided it would be okay to not only put it up on their live, which is my understanding. I wouldn't go look at it. People told, I wouldn't go. There was no way I was going to look at that travesty of, I don't mean the person, I mean the topic. I don't know the person. But it's my understanding they put it up for you to read and also read it out loud. A minor child's journal entry is what we're talking about here. Okay. So what is worse? Seriously, think about that. The person who confided in who she thought was her friends, or the person who screenshot it with the intent of doing something later with it, or the person who received it and then shared it. Because here's the thing. You know, just because you received it doesn't mean you have to share it. You made a conscious choice at that point in time to do that for whatever reason. You know, it sounds like, because, you know, this person doesn't like Natasha, so they thought it was okay, I guess, that they use a young child diary page to exact revenge or hate on that creator. I don't know. I don't know what the purpose of them doing that was. All I know is, think about what you're saying. Those of you who are all like, it wouldn't have happened if she wouldn't have shown that. I would never do that. Blah, blah, blah. If her intention was to show it and harm her daughter, I'm pretty sure she would have just done her own live stream and put it up there and pointed out to everybody. She didn't. She talked to a couple friends. You all know we've all done it. We've all said, hey, this is going on with my kid, and I'm either worried, or do you think I handled this okay? Or, you know, maybe somebody who's had experience in what you're going through, hey, you know, you got any advice for me? That's not where the problem lies. Problem lies with the person who shared it. Because they didn't have to share it. They made a conscious choice to do so. So you need to ask why. Why would that person do that? And I'm also going to say this. And if it sounds mean, I'm sorry. But it is my feelings on the matter. If you have lost custody of your children to the state. And I don't mean you're fighting this battle right now of custody and your fight. I'm talking about if you have lost your child permanently to the state you live in. Because of your parenting or because whatever, do not comment on somebody else's parenting. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. I'm not saying that anybody has or has not. I'm just saying that I've seen it before. And if somebody has lost their children, and the state has had to come in and take them away, you don't get to sit. I mean, you can't. Nobody's stopping you. It's a free country. In America, you can sit and do that, but it's not without repercussions at all. One sec. I'm very sorry. It's my husband. Okay, so he wouldn't text me if it wasn't important. Anyway, so you don't, there go my dogs. You don't get to remark on other people's parenting and sit in judgment, you know? I mean, you can, like I said, but you're not without consequences. Not without consequences, not without, you know, kind of looking like a hypocritical person, you know. I'm just telling you how it looks. Yeah. A lot of stuff went down yesterday. A lot of hate. A lot of things were said that can't ever be unsaid. A lot of things were shown that can never be unshown. And I know a lot of you have a problem with Natasha. Does she say or do things that I don't agree with? Yep. She does. She hasn't crossed my moral and ethical line that I have set for myself, though. Not yet. Anyway. I enjoy her community, the people in it. She has been very nice to me. Her community has welcomed me with open arms. And look, I've got subscribers, channel subscribers that subscribe to, like I've said before, to other channels that I would never, ever have anything to do with. But I don't say, oh, you can't be here. And I don't say, you know, oh, I'm going to hold this against you because blah, blah, blah. It's whatever. Unless I see, just because somebody's in someone's channel doesn't necessarily mean that they agree with everything that's being said or done. Okay? So I'm not going to, unless somebody's in a channel and they're flapping their gums, and it's not great, then I'm going to be like, yeah, you know, I just kind of want to distance myself from that, right? Does that make sense? And a mail call. Go ahead and just, I guess, pile it here. Oh no, you can put it in there. There's no things going. Thank you, sweetheart. Huh? Okay. So, yeah. We as a community need to do better for each other. We really do. Me included, because we all, none of us are perfect. We are all a work in progress. But we decide what we want to work on and what we don't want to work on within ourselves. And, yeah. So, this, yeah, I didn't sleep very well. It bothers me when I see what I consider atrocious behavior against other human beings. And I'm not going to lie. You know, this constant fight and dealing with the hate comments from another content creator, and we all know who she is really starting to wear down on me. And no, do not say, well, it's your own fault. I have a history with this person. End of story. Okay? This would be happening even if I didn't say a freaking word. Which is exactly how this started. See, a lot of you don't understand that I tried to be nice and help somebody who, you know, again, my only screw up in that was believing that I actually was going to be able to help them. Okay? Because past history had shown I wouldn't be able to. But I wanted to try. And because I tried to help the person, you know how this started? with the doxing of me and stuff. Because I said, oh gosh, don't say that to this person. And then I smiled. I said, honey, you know, YouTube is going to, they're going to say something. They're going to be upset. That's breaking the rules. You know, don't do that. I don't want you to lose your channel. That's all I did. So for a month now, I've endured attempted doxing. I've endured threats against my old manager of my apartments, which my old apartments, which is just beyond me. I've endured, well, you guys know, I'm not going to go through it. You guys have seen it. You've seen what's been done. You've seen what's been said. And I'm not trying to sway anybody's mind about anything. I'm just trying to say that when I come on and say I'm upset at the unfairness and the totally unprovoked attacks, don't say I deserved it. And you know what? If somebody doing something awful to another human, of vile, awful things, and I say, don't do that. Stop it. What are you thinking of? That's wrong. If that makes that, if that means I deserve it, then there's no change in your mind. So, all right. We're done with that for right now, okay? Because like I said, I am just, I don't even want to work on anything today. So, and it didn't help that last night. Here's a public service announcement. Never be sanding things while you're making a video about somebody who's made you very upset because you don't watch what you're doing. I had to throw away product items last night and everything because I had sanded my fingers on this hand, my thumb specifically in this finger. Blood everywhere. There's blood everywhere. And I didn't realize it. Until I was like, God, why is my hand hurt? And I looked down. Ugh. So, you can see this fingernail got it too. Hold on. But it didn't get to my skin. But you can tell by my fingernail here. Hopefully, if it'll show. Can you see? Come on now. Yeah, see how it's... yeah. So, my thumb and my middle finger got it the worst. So, oh, it's very painful. But yeah, I didn't even have the energy to work on anything. You know, there is such a thing as energy vampires, and there's a lot of energy vampires that just suck it right out of you on YouTube. Okay. Now let's get to the happy portion of our video here. So, I want to thank you guys so much for your Etsy orders. I hit 900 sales. I was at 800 and something. And it's you YouTuber supporters that pushed me up over the 900. Thank you so much. You have no idea. I mean, it feels good mentally. I appreciate it. It really, really helps. And I was able to, yeah, here it is. I was able to buy my diabetic arm reader thing because my insurance doesn't cover it because I'm not a type 1 diabetic. I'm a type 2. So insurance doesn't cover it. I have to pay for it out of pocket. And it's $40 every 2 weeks. I haven't had one on in months. I want to say over a year. Yeah, I think over a year. But, and it's not that, because we were just, oh, so broke. It was just that, you know how it is. You're like, okay, well, I've got to go get this. And then it's, well, I'll do it after I pay this bill, this bill, and this bill. And then your car breaks, or the cat gets sick, or, you know what I'm saying? And then you're just, okay, well, I just won't get it. Now, is it a must-have? No, because I can prick my fingers, right? But pricking my fingers for 10 years... is the reason why when I was sanding yesterday and I didn't feel, because there's so much scar tissue built up that the tips of my fingers can withstand a lot of pain before they realize, uh-oh, something's wrong, okay? So while is it needed? No. Is it appreciated and so grateful that because of Etsy sales and donations, I was able to get that. So appreciated. So appreciated. So thank you so much. You see me messing with these beads? These are the beads, and see if I can carefully take them off. These are the beads that I was gifted, that somebody had bought during one of Natasha's jewelry accessory type sales, okay? And two people each bought me one necklace. This is one of them. I'll wear the other one tomorrow. She is not kidding when she talks about how well made these are and the sparkle on them. I'm going to try, but she couldn't capture the sparkle, and I probably won't be able to either. Come on now. Can you see the sparkle? These are gorgeous. They're 60 inches long. I knotted mine because I like doing that. But you can also, you know, just double it and put it on, whatever. I think I might make something to attach in the middle of, like, these two beads that hang down to wear. But these are absolutely gorgeous. They're very well made. The cord that they're strung on is very thick. It's not thin. So that's not, you know, you're not going to have a huge worry of being pulled and busted. I mean, that can happen to any necklace. But, and also, this may sound weird, but have y'all ever gotten acrylic bead necklaces and they stunk? They smelled like petroleum or oil? Has that ever happened to you? Because it's happened to me. And I'm a huge sensory person. Like, I don't, certain sounds will cause me to have an attack, even a mental breakdown. And certain smells will trigger me. And so the first thing I did, in fact, my husband was like, oh, someone sent you beads. And I'm like, yeah, but I got to smell them because, you know, just, I mean, I would have appreciated it no matter what, but you know what I mean? And no smell. These smell great. So, yeah. So if she ever has these for sale again, think about picking yourself up a couple. They were very inexpensive. And like I said, two lovely people bought me a pair of lovely people. Each bought me one. So I have another one that I'll show tomorrow. And I want to thank those people so much. So much. I went to go buy, and these two people said, no, let your two be on us. We'll you know, we want to do that in appreciation for your content and stuff. And see, I'm going to cry. Thank you. Thank you. Drink. Oh. Ooh. See, this is what happens when it's not alive. I'm over here. I didn't do. Okay, so let's get on in here and figure out what we're going to pull out. Ha. Choose to shine. Boy, does that not. Doesn't that hit what I was just talking about before the happy part, right? We all have choices. Some days we want to shine, but we can't. But when we can't, just know that there will be another day for you to shine. Okay? So if you would like to choose to shine today or some other time and you can't, if life has got you down and you're just like, ugh, just know that your sparkle is still there. It's just laying low for the moment. Okay? Your shine is still there. It's just laying low, and tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, next week, next is another day. Okay? So, leggings. Do you sense a theme? These are my Pride leggings. I absolutely love them. June is Pride Month, so I, you know, and that's obviously in 2 months, and you'll see me wear a lot of stuff supporting the LGBTQ community, because that is my community. And I hope that doesn't bother anybody, but if it does, the problem lies with you and not me. And if it bothers you, then you can see yourself off my channel. I'm not trying to be rude. I'm just saying that, I mean, if it bothers you, but, you know, you can stay and hold your tongue and be respectful, then by all means, I'd love to have you. Love to have you here. But if you feel that my support and being a part of the LGBTQ community is a bad thing, then this is probably not the channel for you. And I wish you well if you have to leave, okay? But yeah, these are my Pride leggings. I have Pride earrings. I have a Pride hat. I have a Pride purse bag. Oh my gosh. In June, I just look like a bag of Skittles barfed on me. It's one big rainbow. In fact, I even have Pride earrings I made last year that are just sitting here. But I've been thinking I'd have brought them over to show you guys. So let's see. So let's take that off. And now, yesterday, and I don't, like I said, I don't mention names of who gives me gifts because I don't know if that's okay. And I just, you know, however, I did find out that the person who told me it's not okay to talk about the gifts or show them, is wrong. I feel, you know, it might not be okay for them, but I guess the general consensus is, yeah, do it. And maybe I'll start doing some unboxing, and see how that goes. Doing an unboxing video or even a live so you guys can see the generosity from other people. It's amazing. So yesterday I got a gift in the mail. Well, it makes me smile every time I look at it. And this person couldn't have known that I was going to need all the smiles and the help I could get last night before bed. Okay. And I hung it right after we got it. It's in my room. I can look right across and see it. Anyway, but so I thought I'd take a picture to show you the beautiful tapestry that someone, that a channel subscriber gifted me with. I love it. Oh my gosh. Oh, I love it. I have coloring books that are nothing but cat butts, called the Cat Butt Coloring Book. I used to make magnets that were nothing but cat butts. And I can just hear it now. Somebody's either going to clip me or they're going to be like, oh, Noodle has an obsession with cat rectums or some crap like that. Cat butts, like corgi butts, are cute. But anyway, so that's the tapestry that, and the line going through it is just because it was folded, you know, in the package. But so to that person, thank you so much. You have no idea. No idea how much that helped me last night when I'm laying there in bed and I'm thinking about all the atrocities that I had seen lately. And I look over at that and I just, you know, you can't help but smile. And it reminds me that there are good people in the world. And this is what I'm talking about. You know how I end it, my shows, with, you know, hey, say hi to somebody, smile at somebody. You know, you never know what a little act of kindness, and I'm not just talking about donations or gifts. Like I've said, smiling, whatever. Sometimes that really can make a difference in someone's day, night, week, month, year. So thank you so much for that gift. Isn't that great? My husband comes in and goes, does a double take and goes, really? And I'm like, ah, really? Cat butts everywhere. just cracks me up. Okay, so I'm going to show you, if you remember yesterday, I made a Mukumigane stack and you guys watched me carve it or whatever. So I decided that I was going to take and not only place some on black clay, but place some on transparent white clear clay. So you could see the difference in the pattern and the way a piece looks just because I changed the background color. I'm sorry. I know that's so rude, but the amount of sleep last night I got was like next to nothing. Okay, so this is, oh, let me get the cat butt off the screen. I'm sure you guys don't want to sit here and have that staring at you, unless you're like me. Okay, so here is the, come on now, don't you start with me. Oh, I'm back. This is the Mukumigane pendant on black background. Oh, I really have to work on the lighting here. I do. Let's see, is that going to work? If I bring it over the top, maybe a little bit, I guess. Okay, so this is how it looks on black. I like it a lot. Come on. There we go. Oh, just focus. Isn't that pretty? Oh, look at that. Yeah, there we go. Ooh, that light is hot as Hades. Woo! Dang. It's enough of that. Shoot. So, now, I'm very upset because I made these. And the backs are just, you know, they're organically done. I didn't, you see the little ripples and stuff. Okay, I didn't do any finish on the back. Because I just like the way it looks. It was like a leaf, and I was like, I just kind of wanted to keep it a little bit organic. But because, and this is why I try not to actually make product when I'm upset. It's one thing, I'll sit and make art items when I'm upset, and I don't care if I screw something up or whatever, but when I'm making art, I get very upset, and I tend to lose focus on the detail, and that's what happened with this and another piece I'm going to show you. So I'm so upset, because now, while it might not bother anybody, it bothers me, so that means I either have to not sell them, or sell them at a heavily discounted price than what I would. And you know, Mukumigane is, that's kind of a, it's a time consuming, you know, technique. I mean, you guys saw the cutting, you know, but that's not all of it. Obviously there's the stacking that you have to do, and then there's the reducing of it that you have to do. I'm looking for a light here, folks. And then there's and then there's the actual making and the sanding. The sanding takes a long time, okay, because I do it by hand. I don't have a little, I have a Dremel, but it doesn't have, it's the kind that's on a battery. So I don't have a whole lot of, and it doesn't carry a charge for very long. So it takes a long time for me to sand because I have to go through, I think it's like 10 grits and then polish. So anyway, y'all get what I'm saying. So, when I do intricate, like this one, they tend to cost a little bit more, and, just because of the time it took. And so I'm going to see if I can't show you what happened here. Oh, look at that. Okay. Let's get up there. Come on. Focus. Come on. Okay. So I don't know if you can tell. Let's see if we can find it. Okay. Right there. You see that line? Going through it. Now, remember, I told you, you know, I was going to push it. You know, I place it on the black clay or whatever background clay, and then I put printer paper over it, and I do this. I didn't do it good enough. So I didn't meld them very good. So it looks like it's a crack. It's not a crack. You know, it doesn't go all the way through. It's just that I didn't blend it as well as I could have. Another look. And so it resulted in that line right there. So if somebody would like to purchase this at a heavily discounted price, let me know. I can put it on my Etsy for you as a custom order and sell it to you. Well, I shouldn't say heavily discounted, a little bit discounted, because I have the materials and stuff. And if not, then it'll just stay here and look pretty. Here's the other thing I wanted to show you. Now this is awesome. This was done the exact same slices that I did, right? But I put it against translucent clay. And that's what happened. Same exact pattern. Same block that I cut from. Oh, come on. Well, it's because I keep moving, but I don't have a whole lot of upper body strength, so it's hard for me to raise my arms for this. I swear, you know, I just go back to bed today. Oh, what a day. And I can't even go anywhere because my freaking car needs a battery. Ooh, not that I'd go anywhere anyway. Okay, so there we go. Yeah, it's a little bit better. So there we go. So you can see it's the same exact pattern, but it showed up a lot more different up against the white, right? Grab this one. Ah! Oops. See what I mean? There was a whole lot of difference there, huh? This one, and this happens sometimes, this again, I wasn't paying attention. And I pushed too hard when I was making it, and I didn't realize it until I went to buff it to a shine that I realized I had indented the clay. So let me see if I can't show you the problem with this. Maybe, come on. Are you getting there? Okay, yeah, can you see right here? These are indents in the clay, in the pendant. Cannot wait for that community page so I can just show the pictures. I mean, those of you who bought from me, especially my Mokumigane, you can say, you know, the camera doesn't do it justice, does it? And I'm not bragging on my own artwork. I'm just talking about the colors of the clay. So, yeah, right here is going to be... Oh, there we go. See the indents that come down and up and around like this? Yeah. So, because that bothers me, even though it doesn't affect the structure of it, I'm sure I probably can't sell this. And it makes me mad too, because I had put it on a white background, because I've had a lot of people talk about how they don't have, allergies to jewelry and stuff, or they can't wear stuff around their neck or whatever. And I made this because I thought, well, you know, it's thin enough and it's transparent enough that if they wanted, they could use it. Hold on a minute. Let's see. Ah, Lord. See if this will. They can use it as a window stained glass looking type thing in their car or in their, you know, kitchen window or something like that. But do you see what I mean? It's see-through. It's beautiful. So it makes me mad that that didn't work out that way, because I thought, oh, well, you know. So this will be also up there. I can't do a big discount because my stuff already is I try to keep the price down, right? So I don't, what is going on with this ring light? So I don't have a whole lot of wiggle room, but if somebody wants these, I'd be more than willing to not charge as much as I was going to charge for them, and send them to you in the mail. I'm so upset because this one, so cool looking. And I wish that on camera I could show the colors. It's not going to do it. It's being a booger. All right, y'all. So, I think that's it for today. At least for now. Look at this. 48 minutes. I told you it was a long one. If you hung out to the end, you are the MVP for today. Those of you who hung out to the end. And if you didn't, I understand. It's a lot, especially since the first, you know, 20 minutes is not so fun stuff. So I'm gonna let you guys go. I don't know what I'm fighting the urge to just go lay back. I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm fighting the urge to just go lay down. Not lay down, but like lay in the bed and watch TV or YouTube from the bedroom, and just, I'm really trying to resist that urge. So let's hope that I continue to, because I don't think it helps me any if I wallow, you know, but if I have to, I will, if that makes any sense. All right, you guys, I love you all so much. I can't tell you how much you guys have helped me with like financially and with donations and with just being there. Just the mental part of it is so, it's just so awesome that you guys, you know, that you guys have been able to help me just by being here. You don't even, like I said, you don't even have to comment. Just the fact that you that you see me, and yeah, that really helps. So be nice to somebody. Try to remember that while we're on this computer and in the interwebs, that there are people, actual people with feelings and family and stuff behind the screen. Okay, it's not, you know, a robot. It's an actual human being back there. So sometimes, including me, sometimes we forget. So I love you guys. Hug somebody, smile at somebody today. And if I don't talk to you for the rest of today, enjoy your Saturday night. And if you are going to go out on the town tonight, be safe.